Bloom's Taxonomy is a toolbox that teachers or students can use to classify and organize learning objectives. Its most popular version is based on the cognitive domain and assumes that learning should be structured from easy to difficult in the following 6 steps. 1. Remember. 2. Understand. 3. Apply. 4. Analyze. 5. Evaluate. 6. Create. On the first level, we learn to remember. There is just rote memorization and recollection of facts without much understanding. For example, if we learn about lemons, we want to remember the name, shape, color, size, and that they are sour. Once we memorize these essentially meaningless facts, we move to the second level of learning. On level 2, we learn to understand. We begin to decode information and learn that a lemon is yellow when it's ripe to eat, and if we take a bite, that it's really super sour. We also understand that lemons love sunshine and that they contain lots of vitamin C, which is a great natural antioxidant that keeps us healthy. Now, as we really understand a lemon, we can work with it. On the third level, we apply what we know. We've understood that while lemons are sour, they are also a great provider of vitamin C. To apply this knowledge in a meaningful way, we could boil a lemon into hot water and add some honey. Then serve this hot lemon to our sick sister, who's in need of treatment. On the fourth level, we learn to analyze. This involves examining and breaking down information into components, determining how the parts relate to one another, and finding evidence to support generalizations. We study the lemon flesh, examine the skin, and look at levels of vitamins. We conclude that we can eat everything inside, while the skin tastes bitter and contains traces of toxic pesticides. It ought not to be consumed. Now we are ready to evaluate. We analyze, critique, and compare. To evaluate our lemon as a good source of vitamins, we compare it to other sources, such as oranges and supplements. We look at the following properties: vitamin levels, affordability, taste, and packaging waste. If we evaluate our thoughts critically and without bias, we learn where the lemons score high and where others score higher. Now, after we have learned, understood, applied, analyzed, and evaluated, we are ready to create. As we now really understand lemons, also in comparison to similar things, we can formulate a plan to create our own natural lemonade. It's now easy to come up with a cute shop design, a good name, and a good slogan: natural, healthy, yummy. Bloom's Taxonomy was first created in 1946 by American psychologist Benjamin Bloom. The revised version from 2001, as just presented, serves as the backbone of many teaching philosophies, in particular those that aim towards teaching specific skills. Each level usually comes with a clear learning objective that can be tested. Critics of the taxonomy often question the existence of a sequential, hierarchical link between each level. What are your thoughts? Please share them in the comments below. Millions of students from all around the globe have watched our Sprouts videos for better learning. Thousands of teachers play them in their classrooms to start projects. Volunteers on YouTube have translated them to over 25 languages. Our mission is to promote learning by doing in classrooms around the world. If you are a great explainer and a passionate teacher and you want to help us develop outstanding content, contact us. To support our channel with a donation, visit patreon.com/sprouts.